Ever since Minecraft's alpha days, people have been pushing the game to its limits and experimenting to find its boundaries. In this endeavor, there have been some very interesting discoveries. Discoveries such as duplication glitches as far back as beta 1.9, or the Farlands glitch back before beta 1.8. Today's video is all about exploring the best ways to break Minecraft in the current versions of 1.10 through the 1.12 snapshots. Let's get exploring! Back in Alpha 1.1, there was a glitch that existed where a chunk of the world would be protruding from the ground all the way up to the height limit of then 127 blocks. They occurred very rarely, but were soon patched after Alpha 1.1. Since they resembled giant stone man-made structures, they were dubbed monoliths, and recently, they have resurfaced. You are able to generate these in current versions of Minecraft using the custom world menu. All you have to do is go into the custom world settings, click presets, go to the top, and then scroll right. To the right, there will be a setting called biome scale weight. You will want to set this to any negative integer of your choice. For the sake of the video, I'm going to set it to -1, but any number below -1 should work. All you have to do after that is hit the create world button and then bada bing bada boom, the world will be filled with monoliths. So go ahead and try this for yourself. And while you're at it, make sure to explore those underground oceans with night vision on. It looks pretty sick. Second up are the multiple duplication glitches that are prominent in the current versions of the game. There are many of them, including one where you literally duplicate a donkey. Really, like out of anything you could have chosen in the game, someone decided to choose to duplicate a donkey. But that's not the one I wanted to talk about. Today I wanted to talk about this contraption. This to me is the most interesting glitch machine currently in the game. The way it works is that the pistons, when extending, cause a block update next to the opposite observer block, which then powers the other piston, which then repeats on the other side. Eventually, as it's going along, it will just drop a copy of the blocks on the right side of the machine. It just takes them and it dumps them off, just like, nah, I don't want you here, we're done with you. The thing is though, these aren't real blocks. Even though you may be able to do a nice dance on top of them, as soon as a block update happens next to them, they will disappear. What makes this interesting to me is that it's like the game knows it's not supposed to be there, yet it just lets it happen. So that's it for the duplication glitches, guys. I don't know how to end this one off, so let's just go ahead and skip on to number 3. So last on the list, guys, we have by far the coolest way to break Minecraft. For those of you who don't know, in every world around 30 million blocks away from spawn, there is a world border that stops you, much like Gandalf.
You shall not pass!
Until that is, the solution was found by Twitter user iCurry. He then showed YouTuber AntVenom instructions on how to decompile Minecraft and change the world border to be able to be set more than 30 million blocks away. All the credit for breaking the world border goes to them, and their links will be in the description. So by using this mod, we can now set the world border to be way larger than before, spanning to as far as you can imagine. Now you can explore the world to your heart's content. However, this far out, there are some problems that you will run into. In the world, there are a couple of dark spots, places where if you go there, your game will probably crash, as well as some minor to major block lag. Also, the mobs will start acting strange, sort of clumping up in areas. And much like the block lag, this will get worse the further out you go. If you want the specifics, make sure to check out AntVenom's video, which is solely based on this topic. The link will be in the description. And that's it for this video, so I hope you guys did enjoy the video. If you did, make sure to hit that like button and also hit that subscribe button if you are new. And yeah, thank you guys so much for supporting this, especially the people that told me that they wanted to see this a couple videos ago. So thank you guys so much for supporting this. And I hope I didn't let you guys down, because the video sounds a bit like robot-y and a little bit forced, and I tried not to make it like that, but you know, it is what it is. So I hope you guys did enjoy this video, and I'll see you guys in the next one.